So thank you, everyone, for joining this webinar. I appreciate you guys taking your time out from your busy schedule and attending this webinar. This webinar is about the portfolio analysis from the Project Server 2013. This is me. I'm Parthiv. I work for EPMA. I'm a consultant over here. I've done my MBA from the University of Houston and been working with EPMA for more than 1.5 years, just over 1.5 years. It's been a great experience working with some of the best people in the industry. Just a little bit about EPMA. These are some of the clients that we have worked with or are currently working with. EPMA is an enterprise project and portfolio management consulting firm. We mainly focus on Microsoft Project. We are a gold partner for Microsoft. We're the third largest EPM company in the United States. We work very closely with the PMI and University of Houston, the Bauer College of Business. We are their preferred trainer provider. We actually have one of the largest dedicated EPM training center right here in the in our Houston office. So just a little bit about ourselves. This is not a marketing webinar, so I'm just going to jump right into the webinar, the purpose of this webinar. So what is this webinar about? So before we even start, I will be assuming that you know you guys have a basic understanding of how Microsoft Project works, you know, basically how to create projects, how to load tasks in there, and how to assign resources to these projects. In this webinar, I'm not covering, you know, any technical aspects of, you know, how to configure Project Server for using the portfolio analysis. We're not going to discuss any workflows or how to implement any workflows, you know, in your Project Server. So essentially, what we're going to cover is these three items right here on your PWA homepage, your Project Web App homepage. Basically, the driver library, driver prioritization, portfolio analysis. We'll talk about you know what each and everything does, but just to make sure that you know we're just going to cover these three parts in the next 1 hour that we have. So let's hear this. So as I said, everything I'm going to show is going to be on the Project Server 2013, but the steps for Project Server 2010 are very similar. I don't think there is much difference in the 2010 and the 2013 environment as far as the portfolio analysis part goes. So whatever steps I do, if you are using the Project Server 2010 right now, you can still follow the same steps and still get the same results that you're looking for. So let's start with what is portfolio analysis? So the project portfolio analysis, it is a proven process, you know, that has been used by, you know, a lot of people to improve the overall project and, you know, your organizational performance. Using this analysis, basically what happens is you have a lot of projects in there. You go ahead and rate these projects based on, you know, the objectives that these projects accomplish, the benefits of these projects. So what cost they have, what risk they carry, you know, things like that. You can go ahead and rate these projects for these and compare each other, compare these projects against each other and select the best projects to maximize your return on investment. Now, this process can be used in many ways. You guys can use this process in a lot of ways, but most organizations are going to use it, you know, 90% of the time, what you're going to use this process is for project selection. So you have a lot of project requests coming in. You know, you need to pick the projects that actually provide you the best return on investment. Everybody has limited resources, whether there is limited resources that you can have, limited budget that you guys can have.
So you can, you need to pick projects that are best for your company, that best, determines the return on investment. Now, this tool also lets you do what-if analysis. So let's say, for example, you selected a bunch of projects, and then, you know, you can do some what-if analysis. You can move some projects to start later to see how it impacts your portfolio, how it impacts your return on investment. You can, change the budget that you have. Maybe you initially you have budget of, say, $1 million, and then you can change it to, let's say, $2 million and see what you can do. Things like that. This tool has a lot of capabilities with it. So this tool is not easy to implement. By that, what I mean is there's a lot of work that you need to do before you can actually start using this portfolio analysis part of Project Server. It's not a simple process. So let's start and see what you need to do to prepare for the portfolio analysis part. So there are three steps that you need to do in order to accomplish your portfolio analysis, in order to do portfolio analysis using Project Server. The first thing that you need to do is define business drivers. Now, business drivers could be, anything. We're going to talk a lot more details about all these three steps, but you need to define your business drivers. You need to prioritize these business drivers. Which business drivers is more important to you. And then you also need to configure your resource pool. So as you can see, there's a lot of steps that you need to do before you can actually start using the portfolio analysis part of Project Server. So what are business drivers? Loosely defined, business drivers are just crucial factors that lead to success in business. For example, let's say you could have a particular company could boast of, having solid customer service. Some can say that they can deliver projects quickly. Some say that they have excellent marketing people that can market their projects and market their products. So we can see that, all these success factors, they differ widely depending on the industry that you are in. The scope of your projects, or even the, there could be a lot of market dynamics that play a role in what factors affect your business success. So you can see that this is not in any way an easy task to perform and, define your business drivers. Microsoft recommends that you define anywhere between 5 and 12 business drivers. The reason being that anything less than 5 typically does not capture enough complexity of your organization, and anything more than 12, you'll have a tough time defining the priorities between these business drivers and all that stuff. So anything between 5 and 12 is usually considered good. Of course, it will differ widely depending on the industry that you are in. Now, while defining these business drivers, you also need to, associate them with quantifiable impact statements. And you should be able to measure the impact of these drivers. You should be able to easily tell, what impact a particular project has on these business drivers. So let's start with this. Let's start and go ahead and, define some business drivers in Project Server. I have a dev server that I've created internally over here. It is a 2013 environment, so people that have not seen a 2013 environment, this is what the PWA homepage looks like out of the box. As you can see, most of the things are similar. You have the quick launch bar on the left that shows you the project, the projects, the resource center, the timesheets, and things like that. So let's go to the driver library. This is where we go ahead and define our drivers. Now, I've already gone ahead and done, define some of the drivers so that we don't sit here and, start typing stuff. So let's go ahead and look at one of these drivers and see how we define them. So basically, you would go ahead and give a name to the driver, basically expand into new market segments. Let's say that's your driver. You provide a dispersion for your driver. If you have departments, you can filter these by departments, whether you want to have an active or inactive. And then you define the impact statements for these drivers. So for example, this particular driver does not impact our revenue at all. If it's low, it affects our revenue by, let's say, less than $500,000 and things like that. For each impact statement, you will define how these drivers affect your project. You need to define them. So I've gone ahead and defined, I think I have around 6 or 7 of these drivers defined over here. All of them are active right now. You can track, when you have been modified and who modified these driver statements. Now, you could have multiple stakeholders in your organization that have completely different view of how your business should go forward. Maybe you will have to go ahead and, in that case, you might have to go ahead and define these drivers for each stakeholders. And then combine those two outputs from the portfolio analysis and cherry pick these projects that most affect your organization. So what's next? After you have defined these business drivers, what do you do? Let me get back to my slide. The next step is to actually go ahead and prioritize these business drivers, basically saying which of these business drivers are more important to you as compared to the other one that is being defined in there. Now, in order to do this, you have to go ahead and sit with the stakeholders and perform, pairwise analysis to identify the relative priorities between each of these drivers. So, example, business driver A is more important than the business driver.